Hi, this is Derek Tangren from the Adobe Analytics product team. Today, I want to talk about a feature in customer journey analytics called currency conversion. Those of you familiar with Adobe Analytics know that we have supported the ability to collect your data in different currencies and then have it all be converted into a single currency for reporting. We also have this ability in customer journey analytics, but it is more flexible and provides more options in how to work with your data. Let's take a look and see what we can do with this capability. Let's say that I'm new to customer journey analytics, but a longtime user of Adobe Analytics. As a multinational organization, we've had our report suite structured in a way so each region could go in and see reports for that region in their respective currencies. In CJA, we're setting up unique data views per region to give users a similar experience. We'll use the currency conversion feature to give users metrics in the currency they are familiar with for this data view. In this example, I have a list of SKUs, but they're displayed in US dollars. I want to have a metric to display currency in euros for this region. We'll jump over into data views to use the currency conversion capability. I can start by selecting my base metric of revenue, which has already been added. I'll duplicate this metric and we'll use that to create our new euros revenue metric. When I navigate down to the format options, if the format is set to currency, I'll have an additional option to convert currency. Once I check that box, I'll have a couple of selections I'll need to make. First, I'll need to select the currency code dimension. Depending on your individual setup, you have a few different options to populate that currency code dimension. First, you may be passing in the currency code as part of your data collection. You'll want to make sure this is part of your data schema, as you can bring that in as you would any other field into your data view. You'll need to add that field to your data view before you can reference it as part of the currency conversion. Another option is to use Data Prep in AEP to populate a currency code field as the data is collected. For new implementations, this is a solid solution, and in a similar fashion, you'll want to make sure it's added to your schema. The last option I'll mention is using Derive Fields here in CJA to populate a currency code field, which you can use. This option makes sense if you have multiple report suites you're bringing into CJA, potentially each with unique different currency codes based on the report suite configuration. Keep in mind that the currency code field that gets populated as part of the Adobe Analytics data connector won't work because it's the value collected on the page prior to the data being converted into the base currency in that report suite. To set up a currency code field in Derive Fields for this scenario, you simply reference each dataset ID and the respective currency code for that report suite in your Derive Fields logic. Once I have defined my currency code and added it as a dimension to this data view, it's simply a matter of selecting the currency code dimension and then selecting the currency I want to display this metric in. In this case, I'll select euros. I can then rename my metric to make clear what currency will be displayed. Now, if I jump back out to my report in Workspace, I can pull in my new euros metric. Behind the scenes, we're maintaining a list of daily conversion rates for the last 4 years and doing a conversion for each day in each respective report to ensure the highest level of accuracy. This also helps ensure you'll have consistency in your reporting for those converted values. We hope this can be another tool in your CJA toolbox to more easily work with your data and gain greater insights to action on. Thanks for watching. Until next time.